Hi, folks. I'm going to break in, Ann, if that's okay. What an incredible crowd. But there's a black Jeep in the handicap parking that's honking. Honking, 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 honking.
It's in tune now. That's all right, Alvin. We'll send you a bill at the
Thank you. Thank you so much. We truly are grateful that all of you would come and share the joy of Christmas music with us. Do we have any first-timers? People who haven't come to a handbell concert before? Oh, way to go, way to go. I will be announcing the selections since you probably, hopefully, we ran out of bulletins or programs. Is that right? Does everybody have a program? All right. And if you don't have one, ask your neighbor to share. Friendly? Be friendly. This is a friendly crowd. Our next selection is O Little Town of Bethlehem. I'll tell you a funny little story. We played one of these selections, in church this morning. And obviously, I gave the wrong information to the person who made out the programs. And so it said one of the pieces we were going to play was O Come Little Bethlehem. And we all looked at each other and we thought, we didn't know that we were playing that. So this is sort of a part of that. O Little Town of Bethlehem. This next group called the Virginia Highlands Suite is a combination of four pieces that are, well, they're all related, but they're by the same composer and written for a conference, a handbell conference. I mean, when you go to a handbell conference, they fill up like half a football field with handbell ringers. And if that's not impressive, I'll tell you what. And they, each group does their own thing, but they have several what they call massed selections. So this one was written by Cynthia Dobrinsky, who's one of my favorite composers for the handbells. She just writes great stuff that we can actually play. And so there are four parts, but each one is kind of separate. So if you're inclined, you're welcome to clap in between at the end of each one. This first one is called A Grateful Heart. The next in this group is called Mountain Mist. I like to think of it often in the mornings. It's not unusual during the winter to have fog over the river. And so I kind of think of it like that, where the fog kind of comes in and the sun kind of comes up and shines a little bit, and then it comes back and it's foggy again. So I like to think of this piece as doing that. We have several unique things about this selection. We have chimes. Would you like to? Which are rung the same way as bells, but they're made of aluminum tubes, so it gives a softer, different sound, not pitch, but sound, to certain parts of the piece. And this past Monday, that's 6 or 7 days ago, we had Kathy Colbert here to play Silent Night with us and rehearse. And she got to looking on her phone, and she said, "Oh, there's a flute part for this." Now, this is on her phone, and you know how large the print on that is. And she said, "Well, let me see." So she went home, she printed it out, and on Tuesday, she played it. And I said, "Oh, we've got so much going on in this, you know." She said, "Just try it." We will never play it again. without a flute player of Kathy's caliber. It just adds so much. And the other thing that will be particularly unique about this is a technique that was developed a few years ago, and we've rarely used it, but it's called a singing bell. A few of you brought Kleenex, because that's what that song does to me. And the next one in this collection is called A Joyful Heart.
Thank you.
just in case you forget the reason for the season, not yet, but we'd like to finish this suite with a selection called Grateful Heart Reprise. And we do have gratitude, all of us. To do a patriotic number. Do we have veterans in the audience? Please raise your hand. Oh, yeah. Good job. Thank you. We thank you very much for your service so that the rest of us can enjoy situations like this. And this year's patriotic selection is America the Beautiful. Thank you. Back to Christmas. Deck the halls. This one's the other part of O Come Little Bethlehem. It says, O come little children. It's not unfamiliar, but it's not really a familiar carol. So in your insert in the program, you should have the words for O come little children. You don't have to sing, but you can think about it as we go along with O come little children.
Thank you.
about those upper bells. They have been working really hard on that. And I'm not even going to tell you what the next one is, because you know what it's going to be. Is there anybody who didn't know what that was?
Yeah.
No, don't even raise your hand. he's working on it. and our next one is Silver Bells, which bespokes of the holiday season. And we like to think of this. I like to think of it, well, it is. It's kind of set in a city. And, man, you just need to hear those silver bells ringing, even though ours are gold, but that's okay. They're gold colored.
Thank you.
I'm hijacking the microphone. Each year, Ann Nisbet puts so much time and effort into making sure that this happens, and not just at the Christmas season, but I think all through the year she's doing something towards the bells, and we really, really appreciate all that she does for us. So we have a small gift for her. Thank you, Ann.
This next selection is another one by Hart Morris, who writes music that for the handbells that looks fairly easy. However, he incorporates a few challenges that we've had to work on this one a little bit harder than we thought, but it's kind of fun. Again, the words for this one should be in the insert in your program. Okay, we're going with Sing We Now of Christmas.
Words are in the answer.
Good job, basses. Good runs. Way to go. And now, I know the moment you've been waiting for. Those of you who have those peculiar candles that sort of are and sort of aren't, there's no wax dripping on these, which is good. And I don't know how to explain to open them. I'm hoping that you can kind of figure it out. You bend them a little bit, and they go on. Yay. These are a one-time thing. So they will stay on. We can't turn them off, so they will stay on until they die. So you're welcome to take them home and put them up in your decoration group. Oh. Walt says they'll stay on about an hour. So, you know, you can light your way home. That'll work. Okay, Silent Night, our grand finale.
Thank you.
again, we thank you so very much. We hope you all have a very wonderful holiday season, and we'd like to wish all of you a very Merry Christmas. Thank you.